I am a wartime accident. My mother lived with the kids in an attic in Amsterdam. My dad lived in a closet somewhere else. They would meet in the dead of night, avoiding the Gestapo. Nobody in my family ever spoke about the 22 members of our family who never returned from the camps. When I was born, I could not breathe properly. I had pneumonia for the next 30 years. I was always looking for love from parents who were too busy surviving. My sister committed suicide. My brother became an alcoholic. I got into serious drugs and became numb. My first kiss as a teenager rocked my world. Touch was unknown to me. Of course, I fell in love, but this popular boy did not see me. I always went looking for that touch, guys who would pay attention to me, always trying to heal. At 17, I met a man who fell in love with me. I left home and lived with him in Paris for 2 years. But I was uncomfortable and looking for something else, even though I didn't know what. I started traveling, working, and had all kinds of relationships. I had no idea what love was. I learned gradually about a penis, a vagina. My communication skills were zilch. My desire, non-existent. But my craving for attention, huge. David was everything I had dreamt about. Good-looking, charming, educated, smart. We married 4 months later. We moved to Austin, Texas. We raised children, had 2 cars, a big house. The American dream. He became a workaholic. Stopped communicating, stopped touching me. I threw myself into raising kids, joined a choir, had an active social calendar, and became a volunteer queen. We were so-called the happy family. After 30 years of marriage, we decided to move back to New York. I knew we needed to change. We sold the house and drove across country with furniture and dogs. When we got here, he turned on his heels and said he needed to finish up work and went back to Texas. He never came back. And after 2 years of waiting, he told me he wanted a divorce. First, I felt paralyzing fright. Then it felt like someone had died. Was it me? And completely lost my way in the world. It felt like I was severed from my very soul. It shattered everything I knew. I had imagined, like being alone in New York with no money. In the process, I found out he gambled away our life savings. I was so depressed that it took me months to stop crying. The big white elephant in the room had been the absence of physical contact, and I began exploring Tantra, the art of love. I read, went to workshops, but remained mostly numb. Peter came to stay in my apartment several days. I barely noticed him, sometimes late at night when we had a drink and talked about Tantra. When he left, he hugged me. No, he held me. I felt his body against mine, and I thought, what the hell is this? I could not know yet that this moment would be a dramatic turning point in my life. After 4 months of passionate emails, I started meeting men. I gradually understood that love was far beyond anything I had ever known, far beyond fucking or managing a household. I finally fell in love with myself.